In this video, I'll demonstrate how to import data from a CSV file or a text file. The CSV files are used quite a bit in larger businesses and corporations for transferring data between systems. It's a common file format that is utilized for transferring files. This is an example of a CSV file. It's called CSV because it's comma separated values. So notice these would be the columns. The system will know where the columns are separated by the comma when we bring this into Excel. So let's go back and we'll try to import that. Let me take note where it is located. Now the way you bring it in is by clicking on File, click on Open, and then go and find the file basic. So we'll go under My Computer or Computer, click on Browse, we'll go under Downloads, go wherever it is located. And we're going to choose here to show us all files. So notice it's invoices list. Double click on it. Now, you'll be presented with this wizard. Basically, it's saying this is a CSV file, or comma, or delimited text delimited file. So we are telling it, okay, it's text delimited. Usually you'd know that by wherever you got, of course, the file. That tell you whether it's comma delimited or tab delimited, it could be either one of them. Now you check this option here for my data has headers. What that means is that the first row of your data actually has the labels as to what that column stands for. Then we click on next. Then we tell the system that this is comma separated values. So the commas are what separate each field. If it was tab delimited or semicolon delimited or something else, you'd choose that. But most of them are usually comma separated. Then you click on next. Then you could specify additional types of formatting here. Usually it's not necessary. And then you click on finish. Now at this point, that data from a text file has been imported into Excel. And notice I'm double clicking between the columns to make them fit correctly. Notice it's much cleaner. And now you can tinker with this data. You can create charts. You can create whatever you want to create, filter it, and all that type of stuff. You save it, it's done. Let's choose Save As here. Browse where we want to save it. And then we don't want it as tab delimited. We want to save it as an Excel file. So we go here under Excel Workbook. And give it a name. It's going to name it listed as invoices list, which is fine. And now it's in Excel format, just like any other Excel spreadsheet. Now at this point, if for some reason, let's assume this is a spreadsheet that you created in Excel. Now you want to send it to somebody in comma separated values, very similar to how we got it earlier. Now we click on File, choose Save As, and then click on Browse. Under this, the save as file type, this is where you tell it that it's going to be CSV, comma, delimited file. Click on CSV, give it a name, and then click on save. And do you want to keep using it? Say yes. If we were to go back to that folder, notice it's with commas. So that's how you bring a file in. You bring it in from CSV and you export into a CSV.